Delhi and Chennai, two cities separated by little over 2,000 kilometers, but both currently grappling with poor planning and administrative inefficiency. Rains and pollution are an annual affair, one a natural phenomenon and the other man-made. But neither were the Chennai rains unseasonal, nor was Delhi's air quality unexpected at this time of the year. What was also equally predictable was how unprepared the administration was in both cities to deal with this. Now, let me start off with telling you the situation in Tamil Nadu, where a day after Chennai received its heaviest rainfall since 2015, the city is still struggling to get back on its feet. Streets are still waterlogged and houses inundated. The infrastructure in the capital city is once again seems to be unprepared to deal with this amount of rains. Residents have complained that the civic body authorities are not working fast enough to pump out the water from residential areas. Now, worryingly, the Met Department has predicted more rains on the 10th and 11th of November. State authorities have ordered schools and colleges in at least 22 districts, including Chennai, to stay shut for the next 2 days.
नौ तारीख को एक लो प्रेशर एरिया साउथ ईस्ट बे ऑफ बंगाल पे बन रहा है एंड लो प्रेशर एरिया धीरे धीरे वेस्ट नॉर्थ वेस्ट दिशा पे गति करके एक डिप्रेशन में परिणत होगा और 11 तारीख सुबह नॉर्थ तमिलनाडु कोस्ट के पास केंद्रीभूत होगा। इसके प्रभाव में 10 तारीख और 11 तारीख को तमिलनाडु और एडजनिंग साउथ आंध्र प्रदेश में हैवी टू वेरी हैवी रेनफॉल फ्यू प्लेसेस में हो सकता है और आइसोलेटेड प्लेसेस में एक्सट्रीमली हैवी रेनफॉल हो सकता है 10 तारीख को और 11 तारीख को। फिर 12 तारीख को रेनफॉल इंटेंसिटी कम हो जाएगा जब ये लो प्रेशर सिस्टम पश्चिम की तरफ गति करेगा।
My colleague Mugilan joins us. He's been tracking the situation in the city throughout the day. Mugilan, first of all, just give us a sense of where the situation currently stands. Have the waters receded? And as far as transport and traffic is concerned, what is the latest status?
Since last 2 days, Chennai is receiving heavy rainfall, and in several parts of the city, that is including the North Chennai, still the water is stagnant. And we were in North Chennai area, and we could see the water to hip level in several areas, and people were finding it hard to wade through that water and move to the government run camps. And in the other parts of the city, like where we are now in Payambed, this is a camp that has been run by a private organization where the people in the low-lying areas have been moved and they have been given relief materials. Yes, the government says that they have set up more than 4,000 such camps all across the state, but still people are yet to come to these camps and shelters that's run by the government and the other organizations. And yes, as far as the receding of water is concerned, all the arterial roads are clear now, but in the interior parts still we can see water is stagnant in almost all parts of the city. And as far as the transportation is concerned, yes, the roads are clear now, and as far as the rails are concerned, the trains are being operated with some delay from the Chennai Central, and air traffic is not affected in any way. So now the government, even though the government says that they have in Chennai, they say they have 500 pumps and they're pumping out waters in the low-lying area, still we could see in several places still the water is there and people finding it very difficult to come out of those areas. And power interruption also has been done in these areas where the water has not receded. And as I said earlier, when we went to North Chennai area, there were people saying that so far none of the corporation officials have reached them to ask what they need or to carry out any work to pump out the water and restore the electricity. So yes, even though the government maintained that they are taking efforts and measures to pump out water from the local areas or bring in people to safer locations, the reality seems to be in contrary.
And I understand that there are several people who are standing behind you who are looking to get some relief. I don't know if it's going to be possible, but perhaps you can get in a word from some of them to get a sense of their situation and whether there's enough being done for them.
உங்களுக்கு கார்பரேஷன்ல இருந்து கிடைச்சதா? கார்பரேஷன்ல இருந்து ஏதாச்சும் உங்களுக்கு வந்து அட்டெண்ட் பண்ணாங்களா? ரிலீஃப் மெட்டர் ஏதாச்சும் கொடுத்தாங்களா? கார்பரேஷன்
எதுவுமே கிடையாது. ஊர்ல ஒண்ணுன்னா எல்லாருக்கும் கொடுக்கணும். எல்லாரும்
ஏரியால மழை பாதிக்கப்பட்டது. சென்னை கார்பரேஷன் இருந்து வந்தாங்களா? உங்களை அட்டெண்ட் பண்ணாங்க?
இல்ல, நான் வேலைக்கு போயிட்டு வீட்டுல
சார். நாங்க வந்து பாத்தீங்கன்னா
corporation officials, and so far they didn't get any relief material from the city corporation, but the locals here or the councillors here have arranged them food and stay is what we could hear from people, what could hear from the people here.
Okay, Mugilan, now we'll leave it at that. I know there are several people there who are waiting in queues. We'll come back to you for more. Now, what my colleagues, including Mugilan, have been doing throughout the day is that they've been traveling the length and breadth of Chennai to get you a sense of the situation there, the waterlogging there from several prominent locations. Take a look at these reports that have been filed throughout the day by Mugilan, Shilpa and Shabir.
We are currently reporting from Marina in Chennai, and what you can see here is massive waterlogging even on the beach. This is the area where, you know, stalls are set up, food stalls are set up, and this is also a play area for kids and families when they come to the beach. This is a place where there are a lot of shops that are set up, and you can see how this entire place is just inundated. It's completely waterlogged, and the beach, of course, is a few meters away from here. I'm just going to request my video journalist to pan and show you the visuals. You can see the boats that are parked there. That is where the beach starts. So clearly you can see the extent of waterlogging even here in Marina. So this is a situation that is prevailing across Chennai. In several parts of the city, there is massive waterlogging. Even though the intensity of rainfall has come down, the speed at which water is receding is comparatively low. And that is the reason why several of these areas continue to be waterlogged. And what is also creating a lot of concern for the officials on ground is the fact that the IMD has predicted heavy rainfall for the next 2-3 days due to a cyclonic circulation in the southeast bay of Bengal. And a low pressure area is likely to be formed tomorrow, and it is going to move closer to the Tamil Nadu coast, which will bring in more rains here in Chennai, the adjoining districts of Chennai, and also the coastal districts of Tamil Nadu. So clearly the officers, of course, are on high alert, but you can see from these visuals how even the Marina beach is inundated. This is the beach side where stalls are kept. This entire area is completely inundated, and at this point in time, the only hope and prayer that people of Tamil Nadu and people of Chennai have is that these rains there's some respite from the rains, and the water recede very soon so that lives can come back to normal.
The Met Department have now forecasted heavy to very heavy rainfall in Chennai for next 3 days. And in South Chennai and in Central Chennai, we have seen the situation where the rainwater have receded in the arterial roads. But now we are in North Chennai in Puliyandop area, and you can see the situation here. There is a hip level water. All the people here in this area are now vacating, and you can see in the visuals also people leaving their area to a safer locations. And here the power was interrupted last 2 days ago. The power also is not resumed. They say in last 2 days, nobody from the corporation have reached them or taken any steps to pump out water from this area is the complaint what we are hearing from them. And they also say that this is not the first time that such a situation have come to this area. They say whenever it rains, the situation remains the same, but the corporation have not bothered to take any action is what we are getting to hear from the locals here.
right. Kolathur is one of the worst affected areas in Chennai. And people of Kolathur have been facing a lot of issues. Though there were promises that were made by the previous government that integrated water drain system will be constructed, but it is yet to be completed. And that is one of the reasons why Kolathur is having a problem. And this is a systematic issue as far as authorities are concerned. They say that there is no scope for drainage work, to be expanded or improvised. So they are now coming up with a new mechanism that they have been trying to do. And I'm here at Pattalam. You can see right behind me, this is what the situation is. The cars have submerged. People are without electricity for the past 2 days. People have been facing a lot of difficulty in terms of moving in and out. In fact, some of them whom I met here a few minutes ago complained to me saying that water has entered their household and they are unable to do anything about it. And here the water is knee deep level, but there you can see people are still trying to come out, still trying to find their way to their destinations. The water level in that particular area is hip deep. Sir, aap kahan se aa rahe hain aur kya situation hai?
Pani bahut zyada hai sir. Pani bahut zyada ke till up to hip tak hai. Main apna vehicle udhi chhod ke ja raha hu chal ke.
Acha, aapka ghar kahan hai? Aap kahan bhi? अच्छा, तो अपार्टमेंट में क्या सिचुएशन है? आपको पावर है या पानी आया है?
जनरेटर सब सब है सर.
अच्छा, तो ये जो नॉर्मल इलेक्ट्रिसिटी है वो है? आप कहाँ से आ रहे हैं? आप काम
ओसवाल से केल पे आ रहा हूँ, सिस्टर के यहाँ.
अच्छा, तो सिस्टर क्या, ठीक है. Okay, so there another gentleman telling us that the water level in that particular area is really deep, and it's very, very difficult for people to move in and out. So this is the kind of situation that that is prevailing here on ground. The Pattalam area has been one of the worst affected in the recent rains, and this is one such residence where water has entered the entire household. People have been moved to the first floor is what we are being told. Here you can see how water has entered completely into this particular area, into this particular household. And people who are living on the upstairs, they have been talking to us and telling us that they have been finding it extremely difficult because of water logging. There is no electricity, and they have been calling and they have been speaking to the TNEB officials. They say that electricity will be restored once things are clear. Once the water level recedes, only then electricity will be restored. Otherwise, they will have to continue without electricity for few more days. So this is the kind of situation that people are facing in Pattalam, where water has entered their households. This is at least knee level water, but going forward it's hip deep water, and people are extremely worried after they hear the news that there is going to be more rains, because it's going to be more trouble for people who are living in these low-lying areas.
On Times Network spoke to the Chennai Corporation Commissioner Gagandeep Singh Bedi. As Chennai was battered by heavy rains, the civic body chief has maintained that the situation is under control. He also said that the authorities have deployed 500 pump sets across the city, pits have been desilted, and required aid and mails are being provided since morning.
What exactly is the situation on ground? We saw heavy rains, massive water logging, but thankfully there's some respite from rain. But how is the situation on ground?
The situation today is much better than yesterday. We had actually anticipated this sort of a rainfall earlier, and because of this we had actually desilted about 900 kilometers of stormwater drains and over 30,000 silt catch pits. So the benefit of that we got yesterday evening. When the rains reduced, the entire water actually started receding fastly. Yesterday the water stagnation was heavy because high tide was there. Buckingham Canal was full. The connecting canals to Buckingham Canal, like Kodungiyur area, Tanikachalam canal, which are in northern part of Chennai, were also not getting the water inside because they were also full. As soon as the rains reduced, because of the desilting effort, the inundation has reduced. It would have come to 50% of the earlier levels. Still it is there in the low-lying areas because some rainfall is still there. But we have put more than 500 pump sets into operation. We have teams all across the city. 15 IAS officers are monitoring the situation. Morning we have fed about 1.3 lakh people breakfast, and still we are feeding. Lunchtime we plan to give 2 lakh. Not that all the people are staying in the camps. They are the poor people who may not be able to cook on their own. So the government has told that everybody, whoever needs food, should be given. So we are also putting our men and machinery into the place. Things should improve as of now, but let us be cautious for 10th, 11th, 12th, when again very heavy rain is expected in Chennai.